This is the outside. Brain.
Fantasy.
And this is some of the photographs I took of Einstein's microscopic sections of the brain, stained by different methods.
Einstein brain, right?
Yeah, that's right. That's Einstein's brain. Awesome. From different parts of the brain, you see.
At the end, when everybody gets Hello. Wow. There's more of you with the lights on. Could I ask you to please take your seats? We're going to be starting. I know that many of you have very busy schedules this week, and we'd like to keep you on time and on track. Thank you. My name is Pete Scanlon. I'm the Senior Director of Brand Engagement here at Mozilla. Thanks all for taking time to be with us this week or tonight. I'll get to this week later on. Just a few housekeeping things before we get started. We wanted to start on time, but we're going to run a little bit late. We're going to go as fast as we can, but still give everyone a time to make comments and ask questions. What else do we have? Oh, thank you. Thanks. I'd like to mention that we are being streamed live on Air Mozilla. So a special welcome to all of the press who's joining us from around the world and to our Mozillians around the world. Please be mindful of the cameras at the back of the room as you walk back and forth. Thank you. We will also be having a group photo at the end of tonight's discussion. So please, for those of you with lenses, wait until the end, and then you can come forward and take all the pictures you like, or as many as people will let you take. After the program, we will also have demos toward the back and along the sides in a range of different languages. So if you need a specific language, pardon me, please look for the sign that just says whatever language you speak, and you can follow along. My favorite one, even though we know this is a mobile trade show, could I ask you to please set your phones to silent? Thank you. That's about all I have. It's my great pleasure to introduce to you Gary Kovacs, our CEO. Please join me in welcoming him on stage. Thank you.
Thank you, Pete. Welcome. Welcome to our evening press event. Wow. You know, when we sent out the invite, we got about 11 responses, and I thought, this isn't good. But look at this. Thank you all for coming. You know, a decade ago, a group of technology pioneers led by two of our founders, Brendan Eich and Mitchell Baker, who are both here, could you please stand up? I told them I wouldn't do this. They cobbled another group together, many of which are here, some of which are not, because they believed in the fundamental value of the internet as a common good for society. And above that, they believed that the internet should not be controlled by any one or two companies, ever. And they believed that there should be a set of open standards that we all adhere to enable innovation, economic prosperity, and user control to be at the very center of everything we do. And over a decade ago, what they actually launched was what became the Firefox web browser. Many of you know the Firefox web browser. For every one of you that doesn't use it, what are you thinking? I'm kidding. The Firefox web browser sure was a great way to browse the web, but what it ushered in was a set of standards, HTML, CSS, JavaScript. Many invented it at Mozilla, or partially invented at Mozilla, that everyone eventually adhered to, and the resulting explosion in content was so significant it set the web on fire. A year ago, right here at Mobile World Congress, we outlined an ambitious plan to free mobile. You see, as we as users are starting to move our eyeballs and our attention span to the web through a mobile device, either a smartphone or some new type of communicator or tablet, we are fundamentally in the same place we were over a decade ago, where it's being unnaturally controlled by a few parties. The same call that we heard over a decade ago is being asked of us now, which is to free the web, to create a common set of standards, to create a way for everybody to participate wherever you happen to be and on whatever device. A year ago, we outlined an ambitious plan, many thought too ambitious, and we were joined by a group of really early adopters, Telefonica, Qualcomm, Deutsche Telekom, who said, yeah, we subscribe to that plan, we have a shared vision, and we're going to help. And now, tonight, we are joined by over 23 partners to launch what has become known now as Firefox OS. And of course, the slides don't advance right at the big moment. I'm going to try that again. All right, somebody's got to advance that slide. I'm using an iPhone to control the back thing. It's not working out so well. I'm kidding. And with Firefox OS, it is an ambitious initiative. It's an entire HTML-based device that is going to enable everyone around the world to participate in mobile, just as we had on the desktop. There it is. There's the shot. I'll pause. You can. Thankfully, this isn't live streamed, or is it? Mozilla is at the heart of this, just as we've been in the heart of the web evolution for since 2003. But what's at the heart of Mozilla is actually not anybody's, certainly not myself, and certainly not anybody in this room alone. It's a group of thousands of contributors, volunteers, developers, people who believe that we should be doing good for the web and that the user should be at the center of the web. Over 50% of our code is actually delivered by these volunteers, and they are going to be instrumental in how this mobile world evolves with the web at the center. At the core of Mozilla is the ideals of these people and the belief that their user control, their user privacy, their security should be and should always remain belonging to them. We're having a problem with this. I don't know where to aim it. And in fact, privacy and control has been something that we have maintained and will never waver. And in 2012, we were recognized, I'm so excited to say, as the most trusted brand on the internet. So congratulations to everybody who made that happen. So here we are. We're on the edge of unlocking mobile, and we're joined by some pretty powerful organizations that have helped. And I'd like to just talk a little bit about, where do I need to aim this? Because this is, there we go, the other clicker wasn't working. At the heart of Mozilla, we are not driven by commercial profits. We are not going to take what we have created today and unnaturally prosper for just ourselves. What we do is we are a catalyst. We enable everybody to participate, we show the way, and we are going to be instrumental in delivering this platform, but we are certainly not going to be alone. In fact, we believe that at the center of everything mobile should be the web, and that the web itself is the ultimate leveler of the playing field. Why we want to level the playing field is so we don't just have one app store, and we don't just have one app model or two app models, that any payment mechanism that satisfies the unique needs of users wherever they happen to reside can work. To make sure that over-the-top services can be delivered by whoever and to wherever they actually can, and to make sure that the tremendous explosion that happened once the web adopted a standards approach also happens in mobile. And we fundamentally don't believe that you should ever have one or two companies that approve every piece of content that you and I and 4, 5, 6 billion people want to view or engage with. That's a broken model, and it needs to change. With our partners, I am so pleased to announce that in 1 year, what we've been able to do is take a map that looked like this for the open web coverage, and the commitments that we have now will reach Firefox OS on every major continent around the world. Where am I aiming this? Nobody's told me where I'm aiming this. Shouldn't have to aim it. And I would like to actually pause and recognize the partners that have all made it happen, because being a version one is not easy. Being version one is a rather challenging endeavor. And so all of these partners not only have a shared vision and not only a shared belief, but they've actually put skin in the game. They put people developing. Hundreds and hundreds of developers from across these partners have joined with us through hackathons and hack days and work weeks over the last year, year and a half, to create what we are launching today. And I would like to pause, and I would like to ask everybody from these partners to please stand. And please join me. Come on. I know you're not timid. I'm on the phone with you. And I would like to say, and I would like to thank you on behalf of the 500 million Firefox users and the billions more that are going to connect online over the next 5 years. Thank you. The work that you're doing is very, very important. We're going to get a chance to hear from some of them as we go through the presentation here in just a few minutes. But I thought I'd single out not only the operators, but also the early handset providers whose names are on here somewhere. I'm just going to generally aim, so if I zap you with a laser, please do not feel offended. These, I know the questions come, who are the handset providers that are going to be delivering the first devices? This is the list today. There are more coming. And of course, I want to single out a few that have taken the early step. And we're going to hear from six today in addition to what we're going to show you as the product in just a moment. And as they come up, I want to start with one of the partners that has made this such an important opportunity for us, has showed Mozilla, whose roots are in the web and on the desktop, a little bit about mobile, a little bit about mobile testing, a little bit about how the pace of innovation needs to change. And I'd like to ask Dr. Paul Jacobs to join me for all the efforts that Qualcomm has helped with. Thank you.
What's that? No slides? I'll just ask somebody to change my slides for me. No, I actually don't have slides, but I'm really excited to be here. HTML5 and web technologies obviously are critically important. They've been supported in a number of platforms, but this platform is fundamentally built around HTML5 and web technologies. And really what we're trying to do here is, you know, fill the gaps so that application developers can use HTML5 and get access to all the functionality of the devices. And, you know, it's going to provide a lot of flexibility for the operators in terms of getting applications out. And certainly, one of the most important things that we see is that it's going to help the developers build applications that will run cross-platform. So this is going to create a very, very large ecosystem. So we're really excited about that. And this initiative, the Firefox OS initiative in particular, I think is going to do quite a good job in terms of getting everybody to standardize around what the right interfaces should be for HTML5 and web technologies on there. So obviously, you know, why did Qualcomm get involved in this? I mean, we really see our role in the mobile ecosystem as being an enabler, providing enabling technologies. And we've done an awful lot to work with a broad range of operating systems, and this was a really exciting operating system initiative for us to be part of. And as Gary said, you know, one of the things that we do supporting all these operating systems, we have a tremendous amount of experience in terms of testing and working with the operators and working with the handset manufacturers to make sure that we can bring these technologies into reality and execute them very well, because the consumers demand, you know, absolutely fluid graphics and all the applications to work really, really well on their devices. So you just can't compromise, and we think we're bringing that to the table here. So since the very beginning of working on this platform, we've been the exclusive silicon provider working with our Snapdragon processors. And one of the things that we've really been able to do is tightly optimize the software. So work with the Mozilla developers, make sure that the UI is smooth, as I said, make sure that the telephony interface works extremely well, that the graphics work extremely well, that the multimedia works very well. And we're targeting this platform for very high-volume smartphones. So we're really focused in on making sure that it can work down to the lower tiers of the smartphones as well, so that we can go address that incredible market of all the people who want to get a smartphone, maybe haven't afforded it yet, or those people who see that they want to be part of this open web ecosystem. So we're continuing to work with Mozilla. We will continue on a long range commitment to make sure that we make this the best platform we can, work closely to continue to do these optimizations, and have to say that at Qualcomm we feel very honored and proud to be part of such a major initiative to really drive the full web into mobile. So thanks very much for being here, and we're looking forward to working on this platform going forward. So thanks, Gary.
we got this figured out. Apparently, there's over 700 of you here, so I got to aim high because the number of people deadens the signal. Somebody in this room's got to be able to fix that. So, enough with the talk. Let's show you what it's all about. Last year, we shared with you the vision. This year, we're going to share with you the devices, and we're going to take a look under the covers. So, I'd like to invite Mozilla's Senior Vice President of clicking, Jay Sullivan, to come and give us a demo along with some of his friends. Jay, please.
Thank you. Please. Get this away from Gary. Cool. Hey, how you doing? I think I'm going to wait for my slide to advance. There you go. So Firefox OS is a new mobile operating system. And our goal is to help everybody in the ecosystem, mobile network operators and OEMs, app and content developers, and most importantly, the people coming online to smartphones to blaze their own path. Now, Firefox OS is built entirely on web technologies. Everything is built in HTML5. But just as importantly, it's built on web principles of openness and the ability of everybody to innovate. So web principles and web technology are both equally important. Now, it's a free and open source project. Now, we've had collaborators, many of you are here today helping build this project, but it's not a consortium, it's not run by a bunch of committees. We're building software and hardware with people that know how to build and ship things, and that's really important. So let's take a look at some of the initial devices that are going to be hitting the market. As Gary mentioned earlier, we have handset partners and more will be coming on soon, but I want to show you a couple of the devices. There's so many different colors of this one, I can't even hold it. So these are the Alcatel OneTouch Fires. Very cool, and they come in a rainbow of colors here. So that's very cool. And I'm also going to show you the ZTE Fire. And these also come in a bunch of other colors as well. And we also have support from Huawei and LG Electronics, so we'll be seeing more hardware coming online soon, but those are the ones we're going to talk about today. So let me show you the operating system. Great. So here's Firefox OS. As you can see right away, it's very personalizable. I've been using this as my phone, so those are my lovely kids. So let's take a look at what we've got. So, you know, in this mobile world, communication remains at the heart of what people are trying to do, even as they get online. Cool. So we've got telephony, SMS built in, and of course people can get on the web with the Firefox web browser. And in the social world we're in, people want to get online to Facebook, so Facebook is bundled with the device. Now, as I swipe through here, you'll see a whole bunch of different applications. Many of these come pre-installed with the device. Many I've downloaded from the Firefox Marketplace. And very importantly, many I've downloaded directly from the developer. So this idea of removing the gatekeeper and letting developers, again, distribute software directly to their customers is really critical to this. So let's take a look. I've got all the basic productivity apps you'd expect, email, calendar, contacts. So let's pull up the contacts. I think that'll give you a feel for how deeply we build social into the device. So I've integrated this, I've imported my Facebook contacts, it'll match the people up with their photographs, and now I can scroll through it and say I select William. Of course I can call him or email him, but I can also post directly to his Facebook wall or send him a message. So you can see it's deeply built in. And also, one of the things you probably just saw, there's a lot of cool little user experience candy in there. So it starts off basic and simple, because many of our initial customers will be coming from the world of feature phones. And you give them a simple experience to start, and then you expose more and more richness as you go. And it's a really, really rich experience. We also have many of the entertainment apps you'd expect. So I've got a gallery of photographs, I've got videos, I've got music. And this has more of a cool kind of nighttime feeling. It's a little darker, it's got rich backgrounds, and these apps are very visual applications. So we've kind of got our work mode and our play mode. So let's go back here. And as you can see, we've got all sorts of third-party applications here as well. So let me have a little bit of fun. We've got to goof around sometimes. So let me make a picture here. Oh, I'll see if I can hold this still. All right, so I took a picture of the Firefox logo. And I just want to give you an idea of some of the richer things you can do with the device. See if you can see that. So I've got this device. I cut off half of the text. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and edit this photo right here on my Firefox phone. So I'm going to, let me maybe get a little contrast here. I can go ahead and crop that to get rid of the stuff I missed. Apply some cool effects, maybe a color, put a cool border around it. Save a copy. So now, you know, I've been able to, in like 5 seconds, take a cool photo, do some quick editing, and now I can and take that one, nice framed, and I can go ahead and share it on email or make it my wallpaper or send it to Twitter. Cool. So, you know, just, there's so much to see. Cool. So I really encourage you to find someone to give you a demo afterwards, because I'm showing you like a tiny bit of what this thing can do. It's amazing. Cool. So let's talk about developers. I'll leave this here. Cool. Well, a lot of people say, hey, Jay, you know, how are you guys going to build a new ecosystem? Cool. The answer is there is no new ecosystem. Cool. If you're building for the web today, cool, and most developers are building beautiful, touch-friendly mobile websites to work in modern browsers on smartphones. Cool. If you're building one of those today, you are building a Firefox OS app. You just may not know it yet. So we're not looking to create a new ecosystem. We're going to leverage the millions of developers all over the world that are already creating these things. And you may not know it, but even on the most popular smartphone platforms, cool, most of the guts of many applications actually are what's called a web view. Cool, so people are doing it because it's too expensive to build for the long tail of operating systems, cool, and learn 8 different stacks of native code. People aren't going to do it over time. Cool, the rise of HTML5 and mobile is inevitable. Okay? Cool, so let's talk about what we're doing to evangelize this. Cool. So all these people are developing for the web today. Cool. We have devices coming out in the summer. Cool. So we've recently put some developer devices into the world, and I'll show you one of those in a bit. Cool. We've been evangelizing what we're doing with Firefox OS. Cool. And we've been adding APIs to the web. Cool. So we've added access to the camera, to the accelerometer, to geolocation. And we're not just adding these in Firefox OS. Cool, we're adding them, we're writing code, and we're working with the W3C to standardize, and they'll eventually show up in other browsers as well. Because it's important that developers can use this stuff openly and freely and not for any single operating system. Cool, so while we've been evangelizing, many did not want to wait and got started. Cool, so what you see here is a list of several of the companies, cool, that have already been taking their HTML5 expertise, cool, and doing the little bit you got to do to wrap them up and put them in the Firefox marketplace. Cool, so I'm going to show you a couple of these because there's some awesome apps going on out there. All right. Let's go back to ammo. Now, as we all may know, quality maps are pretty important to a smartphone. Nobody got that joke. Okay. So we thought it was very important that Firefox OS has great maps. So we've been working with the Nokia Here group. As you know, they acquired Navtech years ago. They have great map data and great functionality. And they had a great HTML5 app. So let's take a look. So I've got Barcelona here. And this is a really rich application. I can go into, you know, I can go into satellite view. You can do my favorite thing to get around this crazy week, which is the public transport view. So this is showing, you know, really detailed level of all the metro and bus data. I can drill down even further, and it's going to show me all sorts of details. It'll show all the restaurants and all the transport that I need. Another one that I want to show you is, I want to make a point that HTML5 has some misconceptions. One of the biggest ones is that, well, I'm sure it works great in the cloud, but what happens when I'm offline? It's the web, right? Nothing happens. Well, that's not true. Software is software. Software can take information and store it on hardware. It doesn't matter that it's HTML. So we've added primitives over the years for app developers to store that. And just to show a great example, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to go into, actually, I don't want to silence incoming calls. Maybe I do. I want to go into airplane mode. So, you know, I'm going to travel or I'm going to get on the subway. So for me, I want to use Time Out Barcelona. I love Time Out, and I want to, you know, between my meetings this week, maybe I'll actually get out and see some stuff. So remember, I'm in airplane mode right now, right? So I've got Time Out Barcelona. You know, I'm scrolling around. They've saved the data locally, big deal. And, oh, there we go. So, you know, if I want to see some Gaudi architecture this week, cool, I'll scroll up there. Now, check this out. I mean, this is a really rich, lively application, and it's all working offline. Cool, so if you had a misconception that HTML can't store data, just forget about it. Not true. Okay, so that's a little bit about, you know, some of the more practical applications. Cool, but people want to have some fun, too. So this is This is a different device. This is made by a Spanish company called Geeks Phone. And they've been building and shipping some of the developer devices that early developers have been using. So, I flipped it over here. I'm going to show you a game. So this is a game called Pop It. So Electronic Arts, obviously really important game publisher, building HTML5 version of Puppet. And this is where you'll see that I'm not a 9-year-old anymore, but I'll try. Let me see if I can pop some bubbles. Can you guys hear the bubbles popping? Get the saxophone. Oh, cool. So I can do some, so this is really cool. But still, it's a relatively straightforward game. Now I'm going to pull up one of my favorite games. And something a lot of people didn't expect with all the game physics it has and different things that would work really great in HTML5. And this is called Cut the Rope. Cool. So this is made by a company called Zepto Labs. Hugely popular game, or so I'm told by my 9-year-olds. So let's do some stuff. My daughter can't make fun of me anymore. Dad, you stink at Cut the Rope. That took like 20 hours. Cool. So that's the technology. Cool. Let's talk about the business model. Cool. The other thing holding the web back in a mobile context is, how do I buy a web app? Where are the in-app payments? How does this stuff work? Cool. So we're doing some new things to make the web a first-class app citizen. Cool. The first is we're going to have a marketplace. But, people are going to say, where do I go? Cool. How do I find this stuff? You can't do a Google search for the word chess. You're going to get, pictures of Garry Kasparov. You're not going to get chess. Cool. So you need a place to go to do your discovery, to do ratings and reviews and sharing and all that stuff. So we're going to have a marketplace. Cool. But what's different with our model is we're not going to have the only marketplace. Cool. I expect many marketplaces to flourish. Some may be run by network operators. Cool. Some might be verticals. You could imagine a marketplace around games, right? There'll be many marketplaces. Cool. And as I said a couple times before, and I want to make sure I emphasize it, cool, developers can distribute their apps directly to users and have whatever business model they want. Cool. And the other thing that's really important about the marketplace is our approach to payments is completely different. Cool. In other platforms, your operating system provider builds a credit card relationship with the customers, and they own most of that value. But we have an open model for payments. And what that means is you can connect them to the network operator's payment model and have upfront and in-app payments where the network operator is a full participant again in the customer relationship, which we think is very important. So that's Firefox Marketplace. Now, one of the things that we think is amazing when you think about the future. So this is like the here and now. This is what we have today. But when you think about the way our devices work, we have kind of two compartments. You have apps for the stuff you use pretty often, and then you have the web browser for the long tail. And that creates a lot of things that don't work well together. Search does not work well together. I'm a big Boston Red Sox fan, and I use this app called MLB.com for you Americans, Major League Baseball. Man, I've been on that Red Sox page a million times. And if I go to the top screen of my phone and type in Red Sox, nothing. Why? You can't search, crawl, and index a native app, right? So what happens if you tear down that wall between the web and apps? What if you could search and crawl and index all of it? I could search for the Red Sox on my smartphone. And there's many, many things you could do. You could have a single do not track setting that sends the do not track signal to all the websites and all the apps you use because it's all the same thing, right? You can have app permissions that protect the user in a consistent way. If a website asks me for my location, I say, oh, Nokia Maps wants my location. I can decide if I feel like that or not, if it seems like a good thing. But if your apps did the same thing in a completely consistent way. So those are simple ideas, but really powerful, right? But what we're doing from a user perspective is something really fun with it. And what I'm going to show you is a completely different way of thinking about what apps even are. So, many of you today probably have a device with many, many apps on it. You probably installed a bunch of those. Maybe you tried it once, but maybe you didn't like it. Maybe you just forgot about it. Maybe you only needed it for one day because it was a really special thing. But you have this graveyard of apps, right? And many of them rise up like zombies requesting to be upgraded. That's that big red circle with like a 53 in it, right? Those are all the upgrades that these zombies are trying to do to your phone. So what if you had a system that customized your phone on the fly for whatever it is you were trying to do? Cool. So today in the United States, it's Oscar night, right? Cool. So this is the big party for all the movies, right? So say I want to look up a movie. I'm going to swipe over here. and I'm going to look for the movie Skyfall. I don't know if these guys are going to win any Oscars, but for 10 or 15 minutes, but when I'm sitting with my friends in the living room, I have an Oscar night movie phone. Look at all these apps. I don't have an internet movie database on my phone, but I want it right now because I'm watching the Oscars. Cool. So I can go ahead and use that app. Boom, done. I didn't go to an app store. I didn't say, oh, what are the good movie apps, and look around. It all was delivered to me based on what I care about right now. And it's a very powerful concept. Show you one other example. Say I'm out, you know, waiting in line with my kids. Why is this all about games and kids? I don't know. I can hand my phone to my kid, and they can pull it up. Maybe they don't like the games I have. And look at it. It takes on a little game look and feel to it. Cool. It's showing all these cool games. And now think about it again. No app store search. I did not install anything. But this game is going to come up, and I'm going to be able to play it right away. And it's going to load. And what's going to happen here is some of these things I may get turned on. I say, hey, I want this, right? And then I can always go ahead and add it to my phone. But think of it as kind of single-use applications with the option to keep them more permanently. And so it's very cool. I'm not going to keep playing games for you guys. It's going to drive you crazy. So, but when I, you know, when I finish with this thing, I can go ahead and add it to my home screen. So that's a brief look at Firefox OS. Like I said, get a demo from somebody because I'm like barely skimming the surface, and we're early to this. You know, we have a great future in front of this project, and I really encourage all of you to blaze your own path. Thanks.
Thank you, Jay. And I'm magically delighted that the connectivity in a room in the basement/dungeon of a hotel actually worked, so great job. That's exciting. Stuff's happening. Okay, as I promised earlier, we're going to hear from some of what I call co-founders of the entire project. No, they didn't reside from within Mozilla, but they certainly resided from within the project that created what you just saw there today. And I'd like to invite some of them up to have a little bit of a discussion with you, and then we're going to bring everybody back for the Q&A session, so please stay tuned. First, from Telecom Italia, Franco Barnaby, welcome.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. I'm very excited to be here, talk about this great initiative. I think that one of the success factors of the telecommunications industry over the years has been the fact that we have been able to operate along three characteristics. The first has been openness, second, interoperability, and portability. This has created a great competitive environment in the telecommunications industry. You can talk to everybody. In our world, there are no barriers, nothing that stops you from talking to anybody else or to move from your subscriber to another subscriber. I think that the main players of the ecosystem are rapidly now realizing that the principles of open platforms should be expanded throughout the entire value chain, particularly to the handsets and the services provided by the over-the-tops. Indeed, the lack of these open characteristics could be very harmful for consumers, having an impact on different levels of the supply chain. First of all, the openness of terminals. It is important that consumers have access to contents and applications that are independent from the commercial strategies of the over-the-tops, and we have heard about this. Second, the openness of the application stores. The principle on which the first stores were developed don't take into account the optimization of the underlying network resources and don't make the carrier's assets available to developers. And third, the access and interoperability of services. The new web paradigms like HTML5 allow to extend and simplify the access to applications and to overcome the market fragmentation on the interoperability of the formats of fruition and on the compatibility of platforms. And finally, openness of browsers and search engines. The centrality of network operators in the browsing experience of the customers will allow to integrate carriers' platforms and capabilities into the fruition of web services, opening to new business models more equal and profitable for the actors based, for example, on revenue sharing. The strategy pursued by open platform initiatives like Mozilla is different. Creating a truly open platform based on new sources, mobile operating systems, and new HTML5 marketplace where the web is the real platform. The operators will benefit from a higher control on the mobile ecosystem and consequently will have the opportunity to address specific customer segments and propositions, develop new business models based on revenue sharing, and foster the penetration of smartphones in the entry-level segment, especially in the emerging countries. These benefits will be based on a more efficient use of the hardware resources of devices performed by operating systems, exactly like Firefox, the operating system of Firefox, making possible performances being equal, a reduction of the bill of material. Moreover, the new marketplace will perform a more efficient use of the network resources, exposing appropriate APIs to developers. Telecom Italia is supporting the Mozilla initiative since the beginning. The reasons why we are supporting this initiative can be summarized in two main drivers. First, focus on a customer-centric approach to new services and markets, able to overcome the existing barriers and to increase the profitability of the ecosystem. And second, implementation of a tiered internet to enable new markets with different needs. Mozilla's initiative is an important step forward in this direction, accelerating the open access to mobile web and multimedia services with simple, innovative, and immediate customer experience. Thank you very much. Thanks.
A long way from that initial phone call some time ago. Thank you. I'd like to now invite up onto the stage Cesar Aliaterra. Telefonica holds a unique place in the hearts of all Mozillians everywhere because they have really helped us understand what we should be doing here. And Cesar, along with his team, have definitely been co-founders of the project. Cesar.
Thank you, Gary. And on behalf of Telefonica, I'm very pleased to welcome all of you to Barcelona. You know, just 1 year ago here in Barcelona at the Mobile World Congress, we saw it together a concept that our teams had been working to create a smartphone powered by an open standard. Now, here back, 1 year after, to show that the concept has become a commercial reality. For Telefonica and the telco sector as a whole, Firefox operating system is a hugely important strategic initiative to change the prevailing value chain in the digital world. It is a major step to bring balance back to the telco sector, an initiative that has been supported by the industry behind it, and I'm very pleased to be here with many of my counterparts in the industry. The smartphone market is currently moving backwards towards silos where customers are locked into closed ecosystems and are able to take applications from one platform to another. This is not good for us, this is not good for the developers, it's not good for the OEMs, but it's not, and that's the more important thing, not good for the customers. And it's a huge concern for all of them. We need to change clearly this. Firefox operating system is the answer, clear answer, to make the web the platform, introducing open standards and driving choice and flexibility to both consumers and developers. Duopolies are not beneficial for any industry, and I'm very sure that Firefox operating system is going to help to change this very clearly. For Telefonica also, Firefox operating system is about being able to bring smartphones for many of our customers for the first time. I'm pleased to announce that we, in the summer, we are going to start selling to Telefonica customers in Brazil, Venezuela, Colombia, and in Spain, devices with the Firefox operating systems. And clearly, by 2014, all the operating business of Telefonica, the 26 countries in which we operate, will bring these operating systems, smartphones, to all our customers all around the world. We are very excited and very pleased with this initiative. And we think the potential to fundamentally change the mobile industry will be for the better of everybody. Thank you very much to everybody.
Cesar, thank you. And thank you for your support. And I'm going to break protocol a little bit here and recognize, too, on Mr. Aliaterra's team, Carlos Domingo and Matthew Key, And I'd like you to stand and thank you so much for all your leadership on this project. Where's Matthew? Okay, next up. And remember, we'll have Jan Frederik Baksaas, who recently has made a significant push and has also been there from the very beginning. So, Mr. Baksaas, welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. As since my two predecessors have taken all the principles on this, I'll be a bit more business-oriented on it. I think that this initiative, basically, is something that has surfaced and become what it is today, because a lot of people have been standing up around the same idea. We tried to do that in the operator community on the VAC initiative some years ago, and in a way, I don't know what really happened to it, but at least it disappeared. And suddenly we have something which is a bit more flexible and a lot of forces behind it for the time being. In the Talanoa group, we want to go to market already this second half in Central Europe, in our Central European operations. And it's our ambition to really take the internet to the masses also in our Asian operations going forward. Internet is something that we enjoy in Europe, generally speaking, at our hands, at the tips of our hands all the time. This is not the case in Asia as of yet. But it is there for voice and SMS, and of course we're going to get there with affordable equipment and affordable solutions, which this one is for the target. And we're going to support that. Thank you.
Okay. And if there was truly somebody that helped see the way, the person that answered the call perhaps first through a phone call with Mitchell and then through me is René Obermann from Deutsche Telekom. And I want to personally thank you for all of your help and invite you to the stage to share your observation. Thank you.
As a matter of principle, I always endorse what Franco and Cesar say, and therefore I keep it very brief. And this today is not about us, this is about Mozilla and this fantastic initiative, and I'm so excited, I'm honored and privileged that so many people are in this room, show such a great interest, and it demonstrates that the principal idea was right, and this is going to be a big success. Just very briefly, we will launch the first device in summer in Poland. I hope it's going to go fine, and then you know some other of our markets in Eastern Europe will follow. And this very developer-friendly standard will be key for rapid development of innovations. So eventually, we'll have great services on these devices, and I'm sure it will be successful. From the bottom of my heart, I wish you success, you and your team, and I want to be part of that, and we can hopefully help. Bye-bye.
Thank you again. And I believe we've already previewed the name that's going to come up. Marco Catorce from America Movil, one of the latest additions and a very important addition in a very important and growing market. Marco, thank you for joining.
There's nothing more to say. I believe that everything has been said. I'm here to support the initiative. America Movil wants to launch Firefox OS phones in all Latin America countries where we operate. We believe that this will be a really good alternative for all of our customers, mainly the ones that do not have access to smartphones today and that they are willing to use it. Latin America, countries like Brazil, Mexico, and Argentina, if you see the usage of internet in those countries, is really growing and fastest growing. And we believe that this initiative will bring a really good alternative to our customers. And I wish you a lot of success in this initiative. And I believe that this is the beginning of the end of the walled gardens. Okay? Thank you.
You heard it here first. And finally, from one of our handset providers who has made an early commitment and has also helped lead the way, from where the web was a year ago to where the web is today, through the APIs and the optimizations and the use of a lot of the graphics processing, we have come a long, long way. And largely, Mozilla has been relying on part of our own team, but a lot of the team. And so the team that you're going to hear from next, represented by He Xiu from ZTE, please join me on stage. I'm not there. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
依照中国的这个风俗啊，给大家拜一个年，祝大家蛇年啊吉祥。
According to Chinese lunar calendar, today is the Lantern Festival of the Chinese New Year. So please accept my late but sincere greetings of Chinese New Year and wish you all the best for a wonderful year of 2013.
众所周知， Mozilla 旗下的这个火狐浏览器在短短的数年间在全球浏览器市场占有一席之地。今天， Mozilla 发布全球新的这个火狐系统， 提出了自由开放的产品态度，为全球的终端用户带来不一样的智能体验，也势必将成为整个业界不可小觑的一支生命力量。作为终端手机厂商，中兴通讯期待与更多的伙伴合作，共同为广大的消费者提供更多更好的产品。
As you all have known, Firefox browser from Mozilla has become one of the most popular browsers recent years in the global market. Today, Mozilla announced a brand new Firefox operating system with a free and open ecosystem, providing global and end users differentiated smartphone experiences, and also playing a big role that has growing impact towards the mobile industry. Also, as ZTE is looking forward to collaborate more and more with our ecosystem partners to provide more and more innovative products.
在去年的2012年初的去年这个时间，在巴塞展的期间，在 Mozilla 的这个进军智能操作系统的开始，中兴通讯就接受了 Mozilla 公司的邀请，加盟了。 启动与 Mozilla 的这个合作，到现在将近有一年的时间。今天呢，我也非常荣幸地亲眼见到了火狐的操作系统的智能手机中兴的手机的诞生。明天，中兴通讯还将会在全球率先基于火狐操作系统的智能手机的发布，也欢迎大家参加见证我们中兴通讯的产品。
At the moment when Mozilla initiated efforts of a mobile operating system, and ZTE has accepted invitation from both Mozilla and Qualcomm to build up this collaboration from the very beginning. It was started from Mobile World Congress in 2002 last year, and it has been almost a year. Today, I'm very pleased and honored to witness the birth of the first devices of Firefox OS. Tomorrow, ZTE Corporation will announce our very first smartphone that is based upon Firefox operating system. And I would like to invite all of you to come to ZTE press events tomorrow to witness this great birth of Firefox devices with ZTE.
最后呢，预祝本次发布会取得圆满的成功，谢谢， thank you.
And at last, thank you all and I wish the success of this press events.
Thank you. And that's a long way from the breakfast in New Orleans, so thank you. Between eating and phone calls, it's been a year.
Thank you.
So now, thank you all for being patient while we go through the prepared remarks and show you some of the product. Much more to show, but all of you have asked if you can ask questions, and yes, the floor is open. So I would like to invite the six partners that just spoke, who have made commitments to actually launch devices in regions and on platforms. to join me back up on stage. We've got mics that are wandering around. But I also encourage, if there are questions for any of the others that are here, please, the floor is open and it's yours. So we'll take a little bit of time for questions. I don't know where you want to stand. Okay, well, we get in position.
Not open mic.
Huh? Hello. This is Stephen Shanklin from CNET News in the center here. There obviously are a lot of other mobile operating systems out there, some of which have a lot of market power, chiefly iOS and Android. I wondered if you could explain what kinds of phones Firefox OS will be able to run on that iOS and Android cannot, because obviously those phones are available for lower and lower prices as time goes by. So what markets can you address that they cannot address?
Renee, do you want to start? No, I think. Okay. So it's a great question. It's the question that comes up most often. Look, it took 22 years for the first 2 billion people to connect online over the internet. Most of that was over the desktop. The next 2 billion are going to connect over the next 4 to 5 years. So we're going to double the internet presence in a very short period of time. Most of that growth is going to be coming from what's called the emerging world. And they don't look anything like the rest of us. They don't have the same economic status and the same disposable income. Most are prepaid. And it is there where we believe, which are today the fastest growing internet economies and internet societies in the world, it's today where the Firefox OS devices will be largely aimed. So they will be price points that are very affordable in between those, you know, to that market in an unsubsidized manner. So if you want to think about it in a more precise way, it'll be about mid to mid-high smartphone function for about mid to mid-high feature phone pricing. And most of those people don't today have a smartphone in their hand, so they're going to be coming from the feature phone world. So we think, obviously the distribution will tell us whether that's correct, is that's the right place to start. And then as the follow-on versions come, we'll ascend to the rest of the world and the different levels of consumer. I don't know. Yes?
Can I add?
Yes, please, Mr. Baxter.
I just want to add one, so, I just want to add one thing on
hold
that.
Hold on, can
that
we...
That is local content to play a broader role in each local market than what is the sort of general OTT, which is reaching out to the global concepts.
Yes. Exactly. Anything else?
Okay, take the next question.
Hi, Armando Rodriguez from PC World. It sounds like you're trying to give carriers more power, and this is kind of the opposite of what's happening. Well, in the United States, carriers have a lot of power over, like, you know, their networks and the phones on there. But in Europe, that's not the case. It seems more like the user comes first, the devices are theirs, and there's not as much carrier intervention. What is your thoughts on this?
Well, I think it's best to hear from one of the carriers. Maybe Renee?
Well, I think...
Sorry, how do we turn this mic?
By virtue of this cooperation. Can you hear me?
No, give it. Try that again.
Okay, I'll try again. With this cooperation, we get more volume of these devices into the market. Otherwise, it'll never work. So we have to cooperate on the marketing side, on the sales side. We can also foster things like hackathons or developer days or so. I think it's crucial to work together very closely. And if that is successful, it'll be to the benefit of everyone, mostly the consumer, but also it's very developer-friendly because it's truly open. So I don't think it's about giving power to operators. It's about creating another successful ecosystem, which if we don't do it collectively, it's not going to work. It's hard enough to get it off the ground, but it does require a concerted effort for it to be successful.